Good Shabbos, everyone. Good Shabbos. I would like to ask everyone to please turn their cell phones either off or into the vibrate mode. It would be greatly appreciated. If you need to take pictures during the service, we ask that you use no flash. And if you're going to take any movies, to be go into the back of the sanctuary and take, do not take them from your seat. Would be greatly appreciated. Shabbat Shalom.
Good Shabbos, everyone. Well, we welcome you to Congregation Near Tamid. Out of curiosity, how many of you are from out of town? We have an out-of-town membership special today. Okay? So, membership chairperson, you're all members. Well, we welcome you. We know it's a special day. I'm Rabbi Sanford Axrod. This is Cantor Jessica Hutchings. And normally we have the great privilege of leading services. But today, we have brought in reinforcements. And that is this minion plus one of students who we're very proud of. And they have been studying diligently every day, right? Yes. For some 18 months to reach this occasion. So we have a tradition of turning all of you into Torah scholars. But before I do that, hold on, a little bit of water. See, I'm getting verklempt already. Out of curiosity, how many of you have never been to a Jewish service before? A few. So real quick, the area where we worship is called the Bima, and at the center of the Bima is our Ark, and inside the Ark are our Torah scrolls. And one of the highlights of the service is when we take the Torah out, it'll be placed on the center of the Bima, and we'll invite those of you who have never seen a Torah up close to come on up, and I'll share with you a little bit about the meaning of the Torah, so that you can appreciate what your friends have done. Up above, you'll see the light that is always on, that is called the Ner Tamid, and that reminds us that God is always with us. And above, you'll see a quote that we picked, and it says, "O house of Jacob, come let us walk by the light of the Lord." So the theme of light and God's presence ever present in our life is one of the themes of this sanctuary. And our congregation, in fact, is Congregation Ner Tamid. And so when it was founded, they wanted that whole notion of God's light shining in our lives to be really emblematic of what we stand for. So without further ado, are you guys ready to become Torah scholars? Well, they sound more enthusiastic than usual, so that's good.
All right.
All right. So well, Cantor's gonna help with this. Here we go.
Some of you might have a head start on this. So we have this word, it's called nigun. Can you say nigun? Nigun means wordless melody, which is great because sometimes we forget the words. So you can use any syllable with any vowel you want. You can go yalalai, fa-la-la, whatever you want. Yalalai, lai, lai, yalalai, lai, lai. That's what we're gonna use for right now. So I'm gonna sing it, you sing it back. Yalalai, lai, lai. So you already know it, so you were saying the next part. That's good. So let's try it. Yalalai, lai, lai, yalalai, lai, lai. Try that. Yalalai, lai, lai, yalalai, lai, lai. Next part. Yalalai, lai, lai, yalalai, lai, lai. Now let's do it together. Yalalai, lai, lai, yalalai, lai, lai. Yalalai, lai, lai, yalalai, lai, lai. And this is to help remind us that this is a participatory service, that even though we have these 9 lovely students leading us, that you too are part of the service, and we want you to join in on anything and everything that you can. The next thing I want you to help us participate that you can become Torah scholars, is our prayer Nesim B'chol Yom, the daily miracles. And there are 15 blessings that begin with 6 very important words that make up a blessing. The words Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam, which basically means, thank you God for dot, dot, dot. And today we say, thank you God for bringing us to the adult B'nai Mitzvah. So the melody goes, Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech ha'olam. So why don't you try that with me? I'll sing a bit, and then you sing it back. Baruch atah Adonai, Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech ha'olam. You've got it. So now we're going to try it. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech ha'olam, for bringing us to the adult B'nai Mitzvah. And if that's all just too difficult, you just say, Amen. All right, so we're going to be trying that very soon. To our scholars. All right, and we are going to begin with Lainey.
Boker Tov, and for those of you who are not familiar with Hebrew, good morning. This morning, I would like to share a little bit about holiness. Being holy, what does that mean? Are you a saint? Do you pray every day? Do you attend services daily or just on special holidays? Some rabbis state that holiness is a gift. Rabbi Moses Chaim Lozado says that according to Jewish teachings, the attainment of holiness is not possible through one's own efforts alone, but is ultimately a gift from God. Some Jews might pray on their own and not necessarily attend services, except for the high holidays. The most holy day of the year in most people's eyes would be Yom Kippur or Yom HaKodesh, the holy day. So, will those people be claimed to not be holy? No, everyone chooses to be holy in their own way. Trying to have the right motivation of conformity for holiness can be looked at as being overindulgent and overreaching, which can be pushy it to belong, but really is a false sense of security as it comes to the light of our Almighty. Speaking of light, did you know that a sign of the symbol of earlier times pointed to higher life was fire, which can be cited at the Sabbath candles, Havdalah candles, and our eternal lamp, the Nir Tamid, that hangs in our synagogues long ago, and you will notice still hangs in our sanctuary today. Later you will hear our Devar Torah, which will explain our Torah portion, Vayetzei, which means he went out. In this story, Jacob goes on a long journey, both physically and spiritually, from this home and his family. During this time, he has a dream of a ladder that stretches up from earth to heaven. Within this dream, Jacob makes a vow that if God will remain with me, protect me, provide food, shelter, and clothing, and guide me to a safe return, I will be holy, and the eternal shall be my salvation and my God. Here, he would praise holiness. Many of you are familiar with the religious side of Torah. However, there is also the mystical side of Torah, which is referred to as the Kabbalah. The Zohar states that of all holy things, none is holier than the Torah, and those who help others to study are entitled to be called holy. Today, eight other congregants and I have chosen to take another step in being holy. As our service progresses, you will see how we have grown together spiritually, mentally, and emotionally. So, as we commanded to surround ourselves in fringes, we are fulfilling our mitzvot to our Creator. Blessed Adonai, O my soul, Adonai, my God, how great you are. You are robed in glory and majesty, wrapping yourselves in light as in a garment, spreading forth the heavens like a curtain. As we wrap ourselves in tallit and say the bracha, we feel the protection of God as a loving hug. Shalom Aleichem, peace be with you. We now invite our loved ones to wrap us in our tallitot.
My God, the soul you have given me is pure. You created it, you shaped it, you breathed it into me, and you protect it within me. For as long as my soul is within me, I offer thanks to you, Adonai, my God, and God of my ancestors, source of all creation, sovereign of all souls. Praised are you, Adonai, in whose hand is every living soul and the breath of humankind. Baruch atah Adonai, asher b'yodo nafish, l'chol v'yach kol bar sarish. We continue on page 198.
Please rise.
Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who has given the mind the ability to distinguish day from night. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who opens the eyes of the blind. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who frees the captive. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who lifts up the fallen. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who stretches the earth over the waters. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who strengthens our steps. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who clothes the naked. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who gives strength to the weary. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who removes sleep from the eyes, slumber from the eyelids. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who made me in the image of God. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who has made me free. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who has made me a Jew. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who girds Israel with strength. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, who crowns Israel with splendor. Amen.
Please be seated.
Please continue on page 203. I am a Jew because the faith of Israel demands no abdication of my mind.
I am a Jew because the faith of Israel requires all the devotion of my heart.
I am a Jew because in every place where suffering weeps, the Jew weeps.
I am a Jew because at every time when despair cries out, the Jew hopes.
I am a Jew because the world of Israel is the oldest and the newest.
I am a Jew because Israel's promise is the universal promise.
I am a Jew because for Israel, the world is not completed. We are completing it.
I am a Jew because for Israel, humanity is not created. We are creating it.
I am a Jew because Israel places humanity and its unity above all nations and above Israel itself.
I am a Jew because above humanity, image of the divine unity, Israel places the unity which is divine.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Asher kiddushanu b'mitzvotav V'tzivanu la'asok b'divrei Torah Commanding us to engage with words of Torah. Amen.
Please turn to page 224 for the Hatzi Kaddish.
Yitgadal v'yitgadash shmei rabah v'yamad yivra hirute v'yamlik malhute v'chayechon uv'yomechon uv'chayede kol bet Yisrael v'agala v'agala uv'izman kariv v'yimru amen. Yeheshmei Rabba Mevorach Le'alam u'almei Amaya Yitbarach Yitbarach v'yishtabach V'yitpa'ar v'yitraman v'yitnaseh V'yithadar v'yithaleh V'yithalal Shmei dekudesha brihu Le'alam in kol birhata Vishirata Tushbehata Venechemata Damiran Bialma Vimaru Amen.
Please rise for the Baruch Hu.
Please be seated and turn to page 228.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam Yotzer or uvarei choshech Oseh shalom uvarei et hakol Hamier er la'oretz V'la darim aleya baruch amim Uvto Michadash Behol Yom Tomid Messiah Messiah Visharit Ma Rabu Masaha Adonai Kulom Behochma Asita Mal A Haaretz Hinenecha
Tit Barach Adonai Eloheinu Ashevach Masaya Decha Ve'amel Reor Shasita Yifaruch Asela Or Chadash Al Tzion Tair V'nizkech Ulanu Mehera Leoro Baruch Ata Adonai Yotzer Hameorot.
continue on page 231. Once or twice in a lifetime, a man or woman may choose a radical leaving, having heard Lech Lecha, go forth.
God disturbs us toward our destiny by hard events and by freedom's now urgent voice, which explode and confirm who we are. We doubt like leaving, but God loves becoming.
Baruch atah Adonai, habocher b'mo Yisrael be'ahava.
Hear, O Israel, Adonai is our God, Adonai is one. Blessed is God's glorious majesty forever and ever. Please be seated and turn to page 234 for the Ve'ahavta.
My friends and I would like to thank our family and friends, Rabbi Axelrod, Cantor Hutchings, Pam Poster, and members of the congregation for joining us today as we celebrate the completion of a mitzvah. For those of you who do not know, a mitzvah is a commandment or a religious obligation. God has given the Jewish people over 600 religious, dietary, and social mitzvot. One of these is tzedekah, or as we say, to do the right thing. We take that to mean to do something charitable or to perform an act of kindness. And this is how we completed or performed the mitzvah of tzedekah. The nine of us divided into three groups and set upon our task. The group I was part of included Larry Rosen and Helene Linden. We volunteered at Three Square, our local food bank. We sorted and organized food, both perishable and non-perishable, that had been donated by local supermarkets and distributors. We packed boxes of food and necessities to be distributed to needy families throughout our area. We even handed out some boxes directly to those families in need. The smiles and heartfelt thank yous or God bless, that was the reward we received. This made us realize how fortunate we are and not to take our blessings for granted.
I was part of another group along with Lainey Reininger, Wendy Katz, and Wendy Katz. We created a mitzvah project at Prestige Assisted Living, a local senior facility. The participants were encouraged to interact and socialize. They had an opportunity to have open discussions about various aspects of their lives. Much of these weekly meetings centered around their creative side. They made stained glass candle holders, inspired by Wendy's talk about Mar Cargal, as well as other projects. We offered them a new activity, and by doing so, young and old joined together to share ideas and create beautiful moments and mementos. Our third group, Carol Holdengraber, Joanne Danden, and Hillary Talent, volunteered at Family Promise, continuing CNT's relationship with the Las Vegas community. Family Promise's goal is in keeping with Maimonides' belief, the highest form of tzedakah is to help another to become self-sufficient. Family Promise helps families become independent, dignified members of the community. They accomplish this by helping families find jobs and housing so they can achieve meaning and structure in their lives. Our volunteers helped in the office doing clerical work, saving the organization money, and allowing the counselors more time to work with clients. We should never take for granted the blessings we have when there are others who need a place to sleep or some food to eat. We met the commandment of tzedakah by giving our time to help others. As Jacob fulfilled his obligation to care for the flock, so have we cared for some forgotten members of our community.
Please turn to page 239. Emmet, there is no place where you are not. Even in the wilderness, this is your word.
Emmet, that pen strokes of lightning, white fire, black flame, stir the soul's passion, guide our sacred way. True and enduring is Torah.
Your truth for us is certain and established, now and forevermore. Like Moses, Miriam, and all Israel, we sing out and rejoice.
Please rise. Page 242.
Yeah.
Generations, we will declare your greatness, and for all eternity proclaim your holiness. Your praise, O God, shall never depart from our lips. Blessed are you, Adonai, the holy God. Baruch atah Adonai ha'el ha'kadosh. Please be seated.
At this time, I wanted to call up, we have a couple of members of our B'nai Mitzvah class that are of traditional B'nai Mitzvah age, and we also have some of our religious school students, a couple of them out there, and I wanted to call them up to join us for Yismichu on page 250.
Come on, Ben.
It's a little bit of La Dor Va Dor. Because our adult B'nai Mitzvah class is so inspired by all of you, they wanted you to join in this with us. There's a little dance that we learned this week, so we'll teach it to you really quickly, okay? Because not everybody up here knows it. So it goes like this. Let's see. Who can demonstrate it? Okay, so Adina's going to demonstrate. So it goes like this. Everyone follow Adina. Ready? Yismechu v'malechu techa shomrei 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 shabbat v'kore oneg shabbat. This is the new official dance, okay? You got it? New official dance, not changing. Okay. All right, did everybody get that back there? Okay, you're going to follow. Okay, everybody get that out there. I want to see it. It's going to look really cool. All right, here we go, Ricky.
Please turn to page 257 and read responsively for Modim Anachnu Lach, which means we give thanks.
For the expanding grandeur of creation, worlds known and unknown, galaxies beyond galaxies, filling us with awe and challenging our imaginations, Modim Anachnu Lach.
For this fragile planet Earth, its times and tides, its sunsets and seasons, Modim Anachnu Lach.
For the joy of human life, its wonders and surprises, its hopes and achievements, Modim Anachnu Lach.
For human community, our common past and future hope, our oneness transcending all separation, our capacity to work for peace and justice in the midst of hostility and oppression.
Modim Anachnu Lach.
For high hopes and noble causes, for faith without fanaticism, for understanding of views not shared.
Modim Anachnu Lach.
For all who have labored and suffered for a fairer world, who have lived so that others might live in dignity and freedom.
Modim anachnu lach.
For human liberties and sacred rights, for opportunities to change and grow, to affirm and choose, modim anachnu lach.
We pray that we may live not by our fears, but by our hopes, not by our words, but by our deeds.
Blessed are you, Adonai. Your name is goodness, and you are worthy of thanksgiving.
Baruch atah Adonai, atov shimcha uchana eleotot.
We now take the time for silent prayer.
Rise for our Torah service on page 362.
Adonai, vein kemaasecha,
Into our hands, O God, you have placed your Torah, to be held high by parents and children, and taught by one generation to the next. Whatever has befallen us, our people have remained steadfast in loyalty to the Torah. It was carried into exile in the arms of parents, that their children might not be deprived of their birthright. And now we pray that you, our students, will always be worthy of this inheritance. Take its teaching into your hearts, and in turn pass it on to your children and those who come after you. May you be a faithful Jew, searching for wisdom and truth, working for justice and peace. Thus will you be among those who labor to bring nearer the day when God shall be one and God's children shall be one.
Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Echad Eloheinu,
At the beginning of the service, I had mentioned that we would take a moment for me to share a little bit about the Torah tradition with you. So if you've never seen a Torah scroll up close, now's your chance. Come on up, no matter what your age, stage of life, faith, tradition, please come up. Don't be bashful. All right, thank you guys for being brave. Come close, you can come behind me in front, that's fine. So this has been a long-standing tradition with our congregation, an opportunity to share with you a little bit of demystification of what the Torah is. When we open up the Ark curtains, you notice that we had several scrolls. They're all identical in terms of information. There's the half-size one, others of varying sizes. In total, we have six Torahs, and you know why we have six? Because six were donated. I just thought I'd throw that in. No religious reason at all. But they all contain the same information. They're all written by hand, and they're of different ages. For example, that half-sized Torah is almost 500 years old. This one is one of our youngsters. It's about 120 years old. So Torahs are used a long time if they're kept in good condition. Whether you realize it or not, you all probably have a Torah at home, because the Torah does come in book form, and you may have a Bible, what Christians would call the Old Testament, and the Torah is simply the first five books of that Bible, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. No more, that's it, but according to Jewish tradition, since the time of Moses, we've been writing it by hand, and the person who does that is called a sofer or a scribe. Scribes can live anywhere in the world. Usually they live in sacred cities such as Jerusalem or Sfat. Ours lives in Miami, Florida, and that is the truth. So he comes out every now and again, and he will repair our Torahs. But he now has about 12 children. They've all been trained in how to write Torahs, and they have quite an industry of producing Torahs that go throughout the world. And our Torah scribe is Moshe Jeruin. Well, if you look at this Torah, you'll see that this group, it's upside down, and on this side, you're looking at it, and it looks Greek to you, but I assure you it's Hebrew, not Greek. And you can see that, if we were to take a Torah from scratch, we would take a piece of parchment like this, about this wide, and we would score it with a ruler, and you would see some of the markings, and then using a feather quill pen, you will write each letter lovingly by hand. Some of the letters are elongated simply to justify the margin, but there are no little dots at all. Those little dots are vowels, so all these letters are consonants. You might see a little space to separate the words, but there are no commas, periods, semicolons, or colons. In addition to that, every single word is put to music. So there are people in this universe who've memorized the entire melody of the Torah. Well, each week we read what's called a Torah portion, and then it's wound ahead. And right now we're in the beginnings of the Jewish New Year, so we're in the book of Genesis, and our students will share with you what we're reading. It takes about a year, 6 months to a year, to write a Torah. And when he's all done writing it, it's sewn together, and then another scribe will look on while they read it out loud three times. If there's an error, they use pumice stone to chip off a letter and redo it. But if there is an error in God's name, for example, then that whole section has to be removed, even if it took a month to do. So if we were to unwind this Torah, go past those double doors, probably to the middle of the social hall, and it takes us the full year to read. So do any of you have any questions before the test? Any other questions? All right. Yes?
How old is your oldest?
Our oldest Torah is the little one. It's 500 years old. been around. It's older than me. 125. These aren't original. No, we updated these. That's just this one. Thank you all very much. Thank you. Thank you all for being brave and coming up. I always like to tease you about the test. You know, I'll do anything for a cheap laugh. But the reality is that the test is something like this. We support each other, and oftentimes at a bar bat mitzvah, there are people from many faith traditions. And of course, the Bible is home to Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, among three of the great world religions. And so, think back, those of you who know about Jesus, he didn't have a bar mitzvah. The custom hadn't been invented, but as an educated Jew, Jesus would have known how to chant from the Torah. The same exact words that we read, they've been around a long, long time. So if you make your way to Israel and see the Dead Sea Scrolls, you can see snippets and parts of very ancient Torahs in this language. This culture and these values have been around for nearly 3,000 years. So without further ado, I turn it back to the B'nai Mitzvah students.
You shall not steal, God spoke, but Laban, father of Leah and Rachel, stole from their husband and his nephew the fair wages he had earned. He spent his daughter's dowries too. Jacob stole his brother's birthright, and Rachel stole her father's idols. You shall not lie, said God, but Laban lied to Jacob about his wives on the wedding night. Jacob had lied to his father about being Esau, his brother, and Rachel lied about the theft of the idols belonging to her father. You shall honor your father and your mother and father, God spoke. But Rachel dishonored her father, but not by denying the theft of the idols. This is a family in crisis. Could it be ours? Stealing is the taking of something that doesn't belong to you or you weren't supposed to have. Lying is defined as making an untrue statement with the intent to deceive. And honoring one's parents is a moral imperative a child has to follow to ensure their own long and productive life. Laban was Jacob's father-in-law and the owner of sheep and goats Jacob attended over the years. Jacob made Laban a wealthy man, even though he knew Laban was shortchanging him. He had used up his daughter's dowries on whatever, much to their frustration. Finally, enough was enough, and Jacob and his family made the decision to return at God's bidding to Jacob's homeland. Not trusting Laban and his sons, they did so in secret. But before they left, unbeknownst to him, Rachel had stolen her father's idols. Sages throughout time have many theories, some good, some bad, but it all came down to her being disloyal to her father, which Canaanite culture considered to be a cardinal sin. Jacob continued explaining all he had done for Laban, and Laban tried to defend his claim for Jacob's family and all the possessions. Finally, they made peace with a sacrifice from Jacob's flocks. Then they each went their ways. Sadly, Rachel had not made peace, and she dies in her next childbirth. She is buried along the road to Bethlehem, the only one of the matriarchs and patriarchs not buried at Machpelah. What is gained by lying and stealing, dishonoring one's parents in this life? Maybe wealth and power will come, but they will also disappear quickly. One dies, we will all die. Do you think our deeds won't be known to God? Jacob's family suffered because of these sins. Would ours endure less? What if a parent stole or lied to a child? Would that remain? That child might question themselves, what's wrong with me that my parent or parents don't want me? What will happen to those parents when he is grown? Will he honor them? Lying and stealing from a child like this will surely leave unremovable scars, but the pain will remain. The rewards for following God's rules may not always be obvious, but they are there nonetheless. Jacob's family suffered and eventually made amends, but the pain stayed. Jacob and Laban found peace with one another. Jacob could now view the glorious sunrise instead of constantly looking over his shoulder in fear of being discovered for that which he had done wrong. The same is true of all of us.
Ya undo. Label ben Moshe, Hadarachava but Avraham Visara, Zipporah but Moshe Visara, Leah but Avraham Visara, Esther Gila but David, Vimilka Basha, Tubia ben Shimon ben Avraham Visara, Pesach ben Mendel, Ela but Avraham Visara, Hinda Fega but Mordechai Nachim Vichayasina, Hamavtir. Hazak, hazak, hazak.
Barquit Adonai Hamevarach. Baruch Adonai Hamevarach Le'olam Ba'ed. Baruch Adonai Adonai Eloheinu Lenech Ha'olam. Bachir Batar Banu Mikol Ha'amim Vin Latan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Ata Adonai Noten HaTorah. Amen. Yaakov mi Beersheva vayelech harana valivka bamakom vayalen sham kiva hashemesh vayichak meavne hamakom Vayasem Mara Ashotav Vayishkav Bamakom Ahu Vahile Vahalom Vahine Sulam Mirza Artsa Verosho Magia Hashamayama Venohe Vivenahe, Vehine, Malke, Olahim, Olim, Verotim, Bo.
Adonai Nitzav Alav Vayomar Ani Adonai Elohei Avraham Aviha Elohei Yitzhak Haaretz Asher Ata Shochev Aleha
Negba, Benivrehu Baha, Komishbeho Ta Adama, Ubzareha. Hine Anochi Imach Ushmartika Bechol Asher Telech Bahashivotika El Haademah Hazot Ki Lo Ezovcha Ahad Asher Imasiti Et Asher Dibarti Lach Vayikatz Yaakov Mishnato Vayomer Achin Yesh Adonai Bamakom Hazeh Ve'anochi Lo Yadati.
Vayira vayomar manora hamokam hatse in bet Elohim vatse sha'ar hashamayim vayashkem Yaakov baboker vayakak et ha'even asher sam Merashataya Vayashem Ota Matseva Vayatsok Amen Al Rasha. Vayigra Et shem hamakum hahu beit el vekulam luz shem ha'ir larishona vayidar Yaakov neder lemor im yehiye Elohim imadi Shmarani baderech hazeh asher anochi holech v'natan li lechem lechov uvegeyovosh.
Veshavti veshalom el beit avi vechaya Adonai li le'elohim veha'even hazot asher samti matzeva Yihye Beit Elohim V'chol Asher Titen Li Aser Asrenu Lach.
Vaisa Yaakov, Raglov, Vaelech, Artsa, Vene Kedem, Vayar, Vahine, Ve'er, Basade, Vahine, Sham, Shlosha, Edretzion, Rov, Sihimaleha, Ki, Min, Habaer, Hahi, Yashku, Ha'adarim v'ha'even gadola al pi haber.
Hasfu Shama Kol Ha'adarim Vegalalu Et Ha'evan Me'api Haber Vehishku Et Hatzon Veheshivu Et Ha'evan Alpi Haber Lim Koma Ya'omer Lahem Ya'akov Ahai Me'ayin Atem Vahish Vayomru Meharan Anachnu.
Vayomer Lahem Hayditem Et Laban Ben Ahor Vayomru Yadanu Vayomer Lahem HaShalom Lo Vayomru Shalom Veheni Rachel Bito
Misha Berach is traditional at this time, a prayer of healing. So if there are those of you who would like to say the name of someone special to you who's in need of a prayer, simply stand and say their names, as many names as you would like. Please stand if there's someone that you're praying for. We think of all of these and we hope that God watches over them, gives strength to their caregivers, and healing to those who are in need of help and hope. And now we as a community, we stand in solidarity as we join in our Misha Berach prayer.
Misha Berach Avotenu Mikor Habracha Leimotenu, may the source of strength who bless the ones before help us find the courage to make our lives a blessing, and let us
Torah, 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 Tzivalanu Moshe. Torah, 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 Tzivalanu Moshe. Torah, 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 Tzivalanu Moshe. Torah, 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 Tzivalanu Moshe.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher bichar b'nevi'im tovim beratzah b'divrehem ha-ne'emarim ba'emet. Baruch atah Adonai Abocher b'atzorah u'moshet Jacob fled to the land of Aram. Israel served for a wife. And for a wife he kept watch. By a prophet the Eternal brought Israel up from Egypt, and by a prophet they were watched. Ephraim caused bitter anger, and because of his guilt his sovereign abandoned him and paid him back for his scorn. When Ephraim spoke with trembling, he was lifted high in Israel, but through Baal he incurred guilt and died.
They add sin to sin, making for themselves molten images, skillfully making idols, the work of artisans throughout. They speak to them, to calves, which people sacrifice, they offer kisses. Therefore, they shall be like the morning cloud, like the dew so quickly gone, like straw driven as by a storm from a threshing floor, like smoke out of a hole in the wall. Yet I, the Eternal, have been your God. Ever since the land of Egypt, you've known no God but me. There is no Savior besides me. I knew you in the wilderness, in the land of the blazing heat, when you grazed and were sated. Sated, you grew proud, and therefore you forgot me.
So I have become like a lion to you, like a leopard lurking near the road. Like a bear robbed of its cubs, I will meet you and tear away the casing of your heart. There, like a lion, I will devour you. Wild beasts shall tear you to pieces. You are done for Israel, for who can help you? Where then is your king? Let him save you in all your towns. Where are the leaders of your towns for whom you asked, saying, give me a king, give me leaders? In my wrath, I gave you a king. In my fury, I removed him. Ephraim's iniquity is stored up. His sin is preserved. Birth pains came from him, but he is an unwise babe. For when the time comes, he does not present himself at the birthplace of babes.
I will redeem them from the grave. I will save them from death. Where are your plagues, O death? Where is your pestilence, O grave? Vengeance shall be hidden from my eyes, for he only among the reeds shall be fruitful. An east wind shall come, a divine wind up from the wilderness, so that his fountain shall dry up and his spring shall be parched. It shall pillage treasures, every choice thing.
Baruch Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam tzur kol ha'amim tzadik b'kol ha'dorot Ha'el ha'ne'eman, ha'omer oseh, ha'mdabir u'mechayim, shekol devarav, emet v'tzedek, al ha'torah, ve'al ha'avodah, ve'al ha'avim, ve'al yom ha'shoah.
Shabbat Hazeh, Shana Tatzalanu, Adonai Eloheinu, Likdushav Limukha, Lechavod Ultefaret, Al Hakol, Adonai Eloheinu, Anachnu Motim Lach, Umvarim Otach, Yitbarach Shimcha Bikol Kolchai, Tamid Le'olam Vayet, Baruch Ata Adonai, Mekadesh HaShabbat.
Amen. Simen Tov, Mazel Tov, Mazel Tov, Simen Tov, Simen Tov, Mazel Tov, Mazel Tov, Simen Tov, Simen Tov, Mazel Tov, Mazel Tov, Simen Tov, Yehelanu. Return our Sefer Torah to Aron HaKodesh on page 374. Please rise.
It's Chaim.
What an amazing Torah portion this week. We are told of prophetic dreams, holy places, God calling men to rise to their destiny, indentured servitude, deception, and true love. That love between Jacob and Rachel appears to be realized by Jacob at their very first meeting. In fact, it was quite a remarkable first meeting. Upon seeing her, he lifted the stone guarding the well so that Rachel could water her sheep, a feat of nearly superhuman strength, considering it normally requires all of the shepherds of the town working together to move it. After Rachel watered her sheep, we are told Jacob kissed Rachel, lifted up his voice, and wept. Why did he have such an emotional response to a first kiss? It may have been just physical attraction, or was he sentimental because it nearly parallels the way his father and mother met, or was he upset that he had no jewelry or gifts to offer Rachel or her family? Rashi commented that it may be because he prophetically foresaw that she would die before him and they would not be buried together. I prefer to think that he wept because he was emotionally overwhelmed from the realization that he had just met the woman with whom he was meant to spend his life. Torah tells us that he loved Rachel within a month of their meeting, and he was willing to spend 14 years of servitude to secure her as his wife. What does Judaism tell us about love at first sight? A mystical approach to this question appears in the Zohar, which explains when God sends the souls forth into the world, they include a male and female joined together. When they descend to the world, they are separated from each other. Sometimes one soul precedes the other in descending and entering the body of a human being. When their time to be married arrives, God, who knows these souls, joins them as they were before they descended to this world. When they are joined together, they become one body and one soul. Some of us have had the feeling, beginning shortly after meeting our future spouse for the first time, that we have spiritually reconnected with a long-lost dear friend. I think back about that first date with my wife those many years ago. I didn't actually see any angels around us that day, but I've become more and more sure that they were there. The story of our Torah portion this week all started with a dream. It was a life-changing dream about angels, God, and a destiny Jacob knew it would take his lifetime to fulfill. Jacob thought the holiness of the place and the stone he used as a pillow were what led to the dream and its message. Maybe the ladders leading to and from heaven are around us everywhere we go, all the times of our life, but we just can't see them. Perhaps what made Jacob and Bethel holy is that just once, for a few minutes, Jacob was allowed to see something that we all can only imagine. It would be nice to see something, even in a dream, that would reveal our destiny and the true purpose in our lives, our work, our families, our relationship with God, and our Jewish community can give as much purpose to our lives as seeing angels. Maybe all of us are a little like Jacob when we sit in the sanctuary and think, God is surely in this place. I shall call it Congregation Ner Tamid. Shabbat Shalom.
Please rise. Jacob went on his journey. With each step, he went closer to his destiny, to his Beshert, to his destiny as a patriarch, his historic place and time. But it started with him conquering his fears. It started with him understanding the importance of dreaming. It started with him opening his heart to love another human being. These are the elements that allowed him to see the divine in life at a time in his life when he could have lost hope and his world could have crumbled to dust. Each one of you stands now in this place. Each one of you has ladders that you had to climb in order to reach your goal, your sense of self, your purpose, your conquering of fears. And you did it because there were angels seen and unseen in your lives who encouraged you, that accompanied you, and that told you you could do this. Sometimes those voices come from within, as we'll see in next week's Torah portion when he continues to wrestle with an angel and he becomes a God wrestler. But sometimes they are with fellow students, which is the Jewish way of studying. We study in community. And we derive strength from one another. And sometimes it's really the ability to believe in your dreams. Not just saying that whatever you believe in, you can accomplish. That is very naive and simplistic. It is whatever you really put your time, your talent, your heart into can move you forward in life, can help you climb that ladder. So that where you were yesterday is different than where you are today and where you will be tomorrow. And so you set an example for this entire community of what it means to move forward into life, and to recognize that what makes life special is in the growing, in the doing, in the sense of community, and the discovery of the divine in places that we often do not know it. I see it in your hearts, in your deeds, in your eyes. Nine of you, which begs the question, where is the tenth? In Jewish tradition, the tenth, when there are only nine, is the Torah itself. That Torah stands with you, making you whole. A microcosm of this big community that is here to celebrate what you have done. So let this Torah always be your constant companion in life, your sacred source of wisdom, and a special reminder of the values that you have sought to learn about and now embrace. Chazak, chazak, benit chazek, be strong, and may you continue to strengthen one another, and may your deeds continue to bring strength and holiness to our community. As you bow your heads, we ask God's blessings upon you with these words. Blessed art thou, eternal our God, ruler of the universe, who has kept us alive and sustained us, allowed us to share in the nachas of this sacred moment. Let us say amen. You may be seated. Well, it's so obvious to the cantor and I that they all did this for the presents and the party. So we at least have to give them some presents. So we are going to call upon the cantor was, of course, their wonderful teacher, but she also had fellow colleagues, Pam Poster and Ayala Lid. And Pam serves on our board, so I want to call upon Pam, our temple president, Mindy, and is Ayala here? Where is Ayala? Ayala? To present to the students the gift on behalf of the board and also the certificate that says you have become a bar bat mitzvah. All right.
It has been an honor and a privilege, and I shouldn't have worn mascara today, but I did, to have worked with you for the past 18 months. We joked it was a double pregnancy. We got through it, and amazing. You just did a fabulous job. Modim anachnu lach, absolutely. We have four things for each of you. Mindy's gonna be Vanna for us. We have a lovely book of Torah commentary. thank you. So that you can continue your studies, because as we all know, becoming a bar mitzvah or a bat mitzvah doesn't mean you've graduated, for all of you children out there. It means you're ready to start. This is the beginning of your formal study, and Jewish tradition teaches us that study is a lifelong goal. We also have for you, to take notes in your book, a pen. Come on, Vanna, there you go. A pen so that you can take notes while you read. Two certificates, a certificate for a tree that has been planted in Israel in your name to continue reestablishing the forests of Israel, especially after the horrific fires they've had this year. And a certificate to prove that this really happened and you didn't dream it. Mazel tov to all of you. Continue your study, and it's been a pleasure. We're proud of you.
Mazel tov.
All right. We want to call upon representatives from Sisterhood, Sean Willis, to officially present the certificate that was talked about.
Thank you, Rabbi. So we all felt the emotion with you. And in our role even, we were nervous and hands were sweating with you. And if you looked at us, we were crying and all excited. So we were here with you. Whether we experienced your position now or we're planning to do it in the future, you remind us of all that we can do. So again, I'm Sean Willis. I'm here to represent CNT Sisterhood. And I usually don't come with a prepared tribute, but I did because I didn't want to forget anything and I knew I would get emotional today. Also, as Las Vegas director of JNF, as Pam did state, Sisterhood has decided to present to you or to celebrate and in honor of your simcha to symbolically plant a tree in Israel, especially because of the fires that have happened in Israel. It is always a blessing and an honor and considered a mitzvah to witness a bar and bat mitzvah. But it is even more special today for a number of reasons. One of the reasons is you are our peers, and you're my friends, and we are all so proud of you. You are a collection of nine, which is the largest of the B'nai mitzvah class that we've had in a while. And even Jeffrey and I, there were four of us, and we had a smaller amount of responsibility. You had so much Torah, and you did such an amazing job. I mean, I don't know if you saw us, we were cheering for you. and even as adults, we see what the children can do. We know what the children can do, and it's a lot harder for the adults. And all of you have taken the time. You made a commitment. Although you had busy lives, you had family and different situations, you made this. And again, it was a reminder that with all of the stories that each of you have, those are your lights. And if you can remember this moment and what brought you to this moment and write it and retell it, that's the greatest part of the Jewish experience is our retelling. You are also finally a reminder that what you can do is objective. What you will do is subjective. But what you do is very significant. So thank you for all that you do. And kol hakavod, great job, and yashar koach. Longer than ever.
And representing officially our Mensch Club, Mike Unger.
Well, this is very exciting for me. It's a very, very special group of people. Normally, I make a presentation to a bat mitzvah 13-year-old. This group is different. What's also exciting is you have amongst you a future Mrs. Unger. And this congregation knows we need more Ungers around here. Pretty soon it'll be Congregation Day Unger, I don't know. But on behalf of the Men's Club, we typically make a very special presentation of a pen. Now you say, what's so special about a pen? a pen is becoming a lost art. We go to our computers and we email and we tweet and we message and we've got spell check and we have grammar check and nobody writes anything anymore. So for those people that maintain the art of handwriting out a letter, that's important. It tells a lot about the person, it tells about their integrity, it tells about their intelligence. And I hope you use the pen for good things, for good letters. Incidentally, the pen is engraved Congregation Near Tamid, so you'll always remember that you have a home here. Last thing I want you to remember about the pen is use it to make a big donation to the temple. And with that, may it bring you luck, good health, and congratulations.
Mindy, could you come up? All right, I understand that you have a special presentation. Carol, I call up our temple president.
As our gift to Congregation Ner Tamid, our B'nai Mitzvah class chose to purchase 18 sets of the new Machzor for the High Holy Days. We chose this gift because we thought it was relevant to our Parsha. In Genesis chapter 28, Jacob experiences the caring aspect of Adonai. God tells him through a dream, V'hine anochi imach u'shmarticha b'chol asher telech v'hashivoticha, that he will be with Jacob always, to do all the things that God wants Jacob to do. Jacob in turn vows that if God stands by him and leads him back to his father's house in peace, then he will give back a tenth of all that he has been given in gratitude for his blessings. For us, the blessing of return has been very prominent in our B'nai Mitzvah involvement. Because of our experience of working and praying together, doing mitzvah projects, learning Hebrew and studying Torah, we have been able to return to ourselves and our Jewish heritage. Like Jacob, we have seen a return to our avot and imahot in peace and with a new understanding of what that means. The experience of return is central to the High Holy Days as well. In many of the prayers and songs, we are admonished to return to who and what we are. Because of our B'nai Mitzvah education then, we wanted to help others to experience a return to themselves through the new prayer books. In contrast to Jacob, however, our gift cannot be measured as a fraction of our blessings. Rather, it is given as a small way of showing our appreciation for what we have received as B'nai Mitzvot.
We begin to conclude our service on page 586. Please rise for Aleinu.
Aleinu l'shabeach l'adon hakol latet gedula l'yotzer bereshit shelo asanu kegoye haratzot velo samanu kemishpechot adama shelo sam chalkenu kahem vegor aleinu kecho hamonam va'anachnu korim u'mishtachavim u'modim lifnei melech Mache Hamlachim HaKadosh Baruch Hu.
Remain standing for the Kaddish. If you'd like to say the name of a loved one for Kaddish or Yortzeit, please simply say their name at this point. Thank you. think of many people who have touched our lives. So we turn in our prayer books to 598. With the preciousness of memory, we celebrate and honor the names of those who have gone before us. Their lives inform our lives. Their values are carried on through us. Yit kadal v'yit kadash shemei rabah, b'yalma divrach hirute v'yam lich malchute, v'chayechon v'yomechon v'chayedechol be'Yisrael, v'agala v'zman kari v'yamru amen. Heishmei rabah mevorach l'alam ome almaya, yit barach v'yishtabach v'yit ba'ah v'yamram v'yit naseh, Vietadar, Vitale, Vitalal, Shmedekusha, Brichu, Leila, Minghol, Birchata, Vishirata, Tush, Bechata, Venechemata, Damiram, Bialma, Vimru, Amen. Heishlama, Rabba, Min Shamay, Vachayim, Aleinu, Vial, Kol Yisrael, Vimru, Amen. O Se Shalom, Bimramav, Huya, Se Shalom, Aleinu, Vial, Kol Yisrael, Vimru, Amen. May the one who creates harmony on high bring peace to us and to all Israel, to which we say amen. You may be seated. In a moment, we'll have our Kiddush and Motzi, but I'd like to just take a moment of rabbinic privilege to express a sense of gratitude to our teachers, to Pam Poster, to Ayala, to our cantors who have worked for about 18 months with these, our students, and we are very grateful to have such outstanding teachers in our community. So we can give them our Ner Tamid little applause. There we go. Fantastic, fantastic. We would like to invite, is it family members or friends?
Immediate family.
Immediate family to join the B'nai Mitzvah students for Kiddush and Motzi. You know who you are, you've been told. Which way are they going? Are they going that way or that way?
I'm assuming that way.
Are you sure? Through the, you sure through the back couple doors? After we do our final prayers, we'll invite you to go out through the side or through the back double doors. And it's a very nice Kiddush luncheon sponsored by our class. And Roberta, you said there's four lines?
Yes.
Four lines that you can stand in, and hopefully you'll end up getting some food. All right, we join together in the Kiddush and Motzi.
And God blessed the Sabbath day and made it holy. Al kein berach Adonai et yom ha-shabbat v'yikad shehu. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech ha-olam borei peri ha-gafen. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam hamotzi lechem min haaretz. Amen. And we join for our final song, Oseh Shalom.
Shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael. Yaseh shalom, yaseh shalom. Shalom aleinu
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.